Good morning. There we go. Good morning. I sense a shift. That row went over here this morning. Hello, good morning. We want to welcome you to worship this morning. Glad that you are here. Special word of welcome to you if you are here for the first time this morning. On the screens in front of you and here in the sanctuary, around the sanctuary, there is a QR code. And if you scan that code, then you will pick up this morning's bulletin. And as always, there are resources in that bulletin that and announcements and things like that that are not don't make it into the service this morning. So we encourage you to pick that up. Use those resources throughout the week to continue today's theme on into the week. We will have communion as a part of this service, and so friends online, we invite you to have some bread and wine or grape juice handy, as we believe all are welcome at the table no matter where you find yourself this morning. So have those elements ready, and you can join with us in communion a little bit later. Our Sunday school is taking a break this summer, but the nursery is staffed for ages up through four, and if you don't know where that is, if you go out the doors and first hallway, you can turn left. The door will be right in front of you. We also have a number of things back in this area right here by the doors that have a number of things to coloring sheets and whiteboards and doodle pads and all kinds of things to help because we know that it's really hard to sit still sometimes. So please make use of that. There's also a cry room as well, just right outside the sanctuary where you can still hear and see what's going on in here. We love to have kids in worship, so please make use of those resources as well. As we gather not just to worship, but we also gather as community together. And so I want to invite you to say hello to the people that you are worshiping with this morning. So I invite you to stand and take a few moments to say hello to one another. Friends online, pull out your phones and text those and say hello that you know and love and say hello to them as well. Yours.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're going to start singing so that y'all might come back to your seats, since you're clearly paying no attention to what's happening up here.
Brothers, sisters, come on down to that river. Guaranteed you'll never be the same. There's a fountain flowing from the heart of the Savior. Bring your sins and all your guilty stains. Let the river of life wash it all away.
Here we go.
If you've been searching, carrying burdens, if you've been lost and looking for a home, if you've been drifting, something is missing, you should know that you are not alone.
Come on.
Brothers, sisters, come on down to that river, guarantee you'll never be the same. There's a fountain flowing from the heart of the Savior. Bring your sins and all your guilty stains. Let the river of life wash it all away.
Oh, come on down to the river.
Come as you are, no time to waste, open your heart, don't be afraid, jump on in, the water is fine, there's healing in the river of life. Come as you are, no time to waste, open your heart and don't be afraid, jump on in, the water is fine, there's healing in the river of life. Brothers, sisters, come on down to that river. Guaranteed you'll never be the same.
One more time.
Brothers, sisters, come on down to that river. Guaranteed you'll never be the same. There's a fountain flowing from the heart of the Savior. Bring your sins and all your guilty stains. By the blood of Jesus, everything will change. Let the river of life wash it away.
Oh, come on down to the river.
Oh,
come on down to the river.
Oh,
come on down to the river.
Oh,
let the river of life wash it all away.
If you weren't awake before, you are now. Well, as the people of God, one of the things we also get to do besides be community and sing together is that we get to proclaim this faith that we believe. And so I invite you to join me in the words on the screen as we proclaim our faith in this statement of faith this morning. We believe in God who made the world, loves it, and smiles upon it. We believe in Jesus Christ, who has shown us the human face of God and a love that refuses to be limited, who calls us to a life that even death cannot end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, through whom God reaches us, surprising, prompting, and questioning us, who is the life breath of creation and the source of nurture, humor, and hope. We believe in ourselves as people made in the divine image, capable of great creativity and great destruction, but called to choose between them. We believe that Christ leads us now, calling us to a life that is absurd by the standards of the world, calling us to resist evil, including anything that would degrade or destroy another, and to create and protect love, justice, freedom, and peace.
Let the poor one say, I am rich in him. Let the lost one say, I am found in him.
Oh,
let the river flow. the dead ones say, I am born again. Oh, let the river flow.
Let the poor one say, I am rich in him. Let the lost one say, I am found in him. Oh, let the river flow. Let the blind one say, I can see again. Let the dead one say, I am born again. Let the river flow, let the river flow, river flow, let the river flow, let the river flow, let the river flow.
Thank you.
Ephesians chapter 2. It might sound a little familiar, but God, who is rich in mercy, out of the great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead through our sins, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and raised up with him and seated with him in the heavenly places, so that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace in kindness towards us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith. And this is not your own doing. It is the gift of God, not the result of works, so that no one may boast. For we are his masterpiece, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand so that we may walk in them. And then from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 14. Immediately after this, which means right before this, Jesus fed the 5,000. So immediately after this, Jesus insisted that his disciples get back into the boat and cross to the other side of the lake while he sent the people home. After sending them home, Jesus went up into the hills by himself to pray. Night fell while he was there alone. Meanwhile, the disciples were in trouble far away from land, for a strong wind had risen and they were fighting heavy waves. About 3 o'clock in the morning, Jesus came towards them walking on the water. When the disciples saw him walking on the water, they were terrified, and in their fear, they cried out, "It's a ghost!" But Jesus spoke to them at once. "Don't be afraid," he said. "Take courage. I am here." Then Peter called to the Lord, "Lord, if it's really you, tell me to come to you walking on the water." Jesus said, "Yes, come." So Peter went over the side of the boat and walked on the water towards Jesus. But when he saw the strong wind and the waves, he was terrified and began to sink. "Save me, Lord," he shouted. Jesus immediately reached out and grabbed him. "You have so little faith," Jesus said. "Why did you doubt me?" Then they climbed back into the boat and the wind stopped. I love Peter. I really, really do. For as many people as we look at in the Bible stories, and think, wow, they're so amazing. Peter is so us, right? He's like, he's this I'm all in or I'm all out kind of guy, right? One minute he's professing Jesus, "I will never, ever leave you alone." And a few hours later, he's like, "I don't know him," right? Or he's declaring that Jesus is the Messiah. And the next moment, Jesus is looking at him going, "Get behind me, Satan." Right? He's all in or not. And it's easy to ask why. I mean, why doesn't Peter get it? Like, Jesus is right there, right? I want to believe that if I were hanging out with Jesus, I would get it, right? But Peter is so back and forth. He's so wishy-washy. But I think, as I said, Peter is us. He really is. Remember when last week I talked about how grace never, ever gives up on us, right? Never, ever. And grace never gives up on us because we as people leak, right? We leak constantly. Like, we talk here in the service and we go, "Yes, I'm a beloved one of God." And then we walk out of these doors and we're like, "I'm not good enough for God to use." Or we say, "Yes, God's grace has found me. This is fabulous." And then we go, "Well, there's no way God could forgive that I've done." We go, "Oh, God loves me as I am." And we turn around and we go, well, I hope I'm good enough for God. Right? See how we leak? Like, we hear the message. We are filled with God's grace. And then that truth leaks out of us. And we are left wondering if we're good enough or if God really, really, truly loves us the way that God says. And so we have to be refilled with grace again and again and again. It's one of the reasons we gather on weekends here, so that we can be refilled with God's grace because we leak. But back to Peter. Again, how could Peter really not get it? He is sitting, sleeping, walking with Jesus. And that's true, but Peter's problem is not a seeing problem. Peter's problem is a believing problem. Take today's story, for instance. Right? So Jesus has just fed 5,000 plus people with 5 loaves and 2 fish. I don't know. That's pretty amazing in my book. You could have left the fish out in my lunch, but you know. But that's pretty amazing. And Jesus says, we've done this. Okay, disciples, get in the boat and go across the lake. And I'm going to take care of all these people. Now, I don't know about you, but the introverted side of me would go, I am so in the boat, right? But Jesus sends them all home, right? And then he takes some me time, good for Jesus. He takes some me time, and he spends some time in prayer and in quiet time, solitude time. And the disciples are out on this huge lake, and take note. The scriptures tell us they are in trouble because there are high winds and waves going on. But they are not scared until they see Jesus walking towards them. Well, I don't know about you, but I would be a little nervous if I was in a boat with really big waves and winds and that. But remember, some of these men are fishermen. This is not the first time they have been on the lake. And probably not the first time they have been on the lake in a storm. It is not their first rodeo on this lake. So they're not scared until suddenly they see a person walking towards them. Okay, that'd make me a little nervous, right? Because that's not really a common thing that happens. But once they see Jesus, then it seems like they forget everything else. At least Peter seems to. He's just focused on Jesus, right? And Jesus yells out to everybody, don't be afraid. It's me. It's really me. Now, if he just fed 5,000 people with 5 loaves and 2 fish, why would he not be able to walk on water? Just ask him, right? But he says, hey, don't worry. It is me. And Peter, love Peter. Hey, Jesus, if it's really you, then let's do another miracle. Let me walk on water, right? And Jesus calls his bluff. He's like, sure, come on out. Now Peter has a choice to make, right? And I want to commend Peter because he has the courage to get out of the boat, right? I think some of us would just go, I'll wait until you come here. It's all good. Right? But he gets the courage to get out of the boat because his eyes are focused on Jesus. Nothing else. And Peter, like we kind of scoop over this or race over this part of the story, but Peter gets out of the boat and he actually is walking on water. And he does it for a little bit because he does it long enough to get close to Jesus, right? And he is fine until he takes his eyes off of Jesus. And when he starts paying more attention to the wind and the waves around him than he does to Jesus, what happens? He sinks, right? His belief turns to fear and he sinks. And Jesus responds, oh, Peter, you have so little faith. Why did you doubt me? And he grabs Peter's hand, and together they go back to the boat. So little faith. What would you have done in that instance? Would you have had the courage to get out of the boat? Or would you have, and be honest with yourself, because I think I might have been like, I don't know. Like, maybe I'll put a foot over the side, see if it really works, right? But I don't know that I would have the courage to get out of the boat. Or maybe I would have because I know I can swim and float. I don't know. But Peter does it, right? But I think I would have done it not because I trusted Jesus, but because I knew I had the skills to not drown. That is not the same thing as climbing out of the boat and believing, trusting Jesus' promise, right? Because when Jesus says, all right, Peter, come on out, there is a promise there that says you will not sink. And Peter is fine until he starts to doubt the promise. It's not, my friends, that God's grace is not here for us. We just don't believe it. We don't. It's like we have to see it. We have to see evidence of it before we will believe that God's grace is really there for us all the time. But what if, as is so often the case in the kingdom's economy, is what if we have to believe before we can see? I love the Santa Claus movies. I don't know about you, but you know, they're with Tim Allen, and you know, and Santa Claus falls off his roof and he puts on the suit and he falls prey to the Santa Claus, C-L-A-U-S-E, right? And he becomes Santa Claus. And so in the first movie, Scott Calvin finds himself at the North Pole, because he's the new Santa, right? He put on the suit. And he's talking to Judy the elf, who has already rebuffed him, because he's like, well, you're kind of cute. And she's like, I have socks older than you, right? But he's looking out the window, and he goes, I can't believe this. He says, look, you're a nice elf. And Judy goes, thanks. And Scott's response is, but this is a dream. He says, I mean, this is fabulous, as he looks out the balcony, and he's like, is that a polar bear directing traffic? And Judy is like, well, yeah, you know. And he goes, I see it, but I don't believe it. And Judy laughs and says, you're missing the point. Scott Calvin says, what is the point? And Judy says, seeing isn't believing. Believing is seeing. So kids don't have to see this place to know that it's here. They just know. My friends, the same is true for us in God's grace. When we believe it, we will see it. When we believe it, we will see it in the most surprising places and ways. Remember, God's grace is God's unconditional love for us, which gives us beloved one status always. God's grace is God's unconditional love for us. And when we believe that that love is truly for me all the time, then we will see it. Think about your own life. I was thinking over mine this past week. And I was thinking about the time when I was in my life when I was trying so hard to please God that there was no way I could truly embrace God's grace, because I just felt like I had to strive so hard so that God wouldn't be disappointed in me. And when I chose to trust God's grace for me instead of trying to earn it, I saw grace. And I felt and feel God's unconditional love all over me. When I was diagnosed with cancer, grace showed up in the arms of those who did nothing more than hug me. Grace showed up in sisters who totally changed their life schedules to come and be with me. Grace showed up in meals at my door and cards in the mail. As a single person in this world, grace shows up in friendships and relationships that are deep and true. People ask me, well, what's it like to live alone, to be alone? And I'm like, I am not ever alone unless I choose to be. And there are times, I love you all, but there are times when I choose to be alone, right? But grace shows up each Sunday in the hug of a friend. Grace shows up in a family that keeps in contact, though we are thousands of miles apart, spread all over this United States. As a pastor and a leader in this place, grace shows up in other leaders just as intent as I am to follow God's callings. Grace shows up in the faces of our children and in their hugs. And I love it when they run up here to give me a hug afterwards, or they find me someplace and they give me a, you'll find all kinds of things hung in my office because art should always be hung, right? Grace shows up when I'm sitting with someone wondering what to say. Grace shows up when I'm so tired or discouraged in the moment I want to quit. Where in life does grace, God's unconditional love of you, show up? I can tell you this. If you believe that it is there for you, before you ever even see it, if you believe, you will see. And once you believe, you'll see God's grace all over the place. But it is in believing that we see. Back to Peter. Peter receives God's grace again and again and again because Peter messes up again and again and again, right? Like, and so our mess ups, our doubts, our unbelief doesn't negate God's grace. Nothing negates God's grace. Nothing. Nothing we do is going to stop God's grace from existing all around us and in us if we will only believe. It is always there. It is always running after, fighting for us, wanting us to trust. It is always there. Every mess up, every breakdown, every falling, grace is there waiting with open arms to love you, to love me, back to belief, love us back to help, love us back to grace itself. My friends, I beg of you and me that we would believe in grace, that we might experience God's grace again and again and again and again. As Scripture promises, grace upon grace upon grace upon grace is ours. Believe it so you will see it. Will you pray with me, please? God, because our world isn't filled with grace so often, it is so hard for us to truly believe that your grace never gives up on us. But you have told us time and again, you have given us this promise that your grace is for us, that in your eyes we are all beloved ones. Whether we are having the best day of our life or the worst day of our life, your grace loves us. So God, instead of kind of standing back and crossing our arms and say, prove it, help us have faith. Help us believe and trust that your grace is for us. Always and forever. Amen.
Would you stand with us? Let's just make this a statement of faith. Here we go.
Great is your faith. Oh,
Amen. Well, God's grace is the one that calls, is the thing that calls us to this table as well. A table of grace, of unconditional love, and a table that reminds us that we are God's beloved ones. And so, friends online, I invite you to hold your elements as I hold the elements here for us in the sanctuary. And I invite you all to join me in the words of this beloved meal. On the night Jesus showed his greatest love for us, he took a piece of bread, gave thanks for it, blessed it, and gave it to his disciples as he gives it to us today, saying, "Take and eat, for this is my body given for you. Whenever you eat of this bread, do it and remember me." And then as I hold the wine, we continue. After supper, he took a cup of wine, gave thanks for it and blessed it, and gave it to his disciples as he gives it to us today, saying, "Take and drink. For this is the new promise in my blood, shed for you and all people for the forgiveness of all your sins. Whenever you drink from this cup, do it and remember me." And as we remember and as we come, I invite you to pray with me the prayer Jesus prayed. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. Friends online, we invite you to share the elements with each other with words such as, this is the body of Christ given for you. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. If you have someone with you who is not taking the elements this morning, we invite you to give them words of blessing, and whatever words come to your heart are the correct words. If you're communing by yourself this morning, remember that you are never truly alone. And that this morning, as you take communion, wherever you find yourselves, you also commune with all of the saints. For those of us here in the sanctuary, there will be two stations here in the front. We'll come to the center aisle and then come forward. You'll get a little squirt of hand sanitizer, and then you'll receive a piece of bread. And we ask that you take that bread and dip it in the wine, which is in the larger chalices, or there's grape juice in smaller bowls if you prefer. We also have gluten-free wafers and a bowl of juice just for gluten-free wafers. If you need those, let your server know, because we're more than happy to provide those for you as well. If you have littles that take of the elements, if you have them hold their hands out, that is a sign to our servers that they get to receive the elements. Otherwise, we will give them a blessing. And if anybody comes this morning, and you choose for whatever reason to not partake of the elements, simply come forward, let us know, and we'd love to give you some words of blessing this morning as well. This is also the time when we take this morning's offering. You can drop it in the basket there in the middle aisle as you come forward. Or if you pick up the bulletin, there are ways to do offering electronically. And if that is more to the way that you operate, and we thank you in advance for your support of the mission and ministry of this place we call faith. This is truly the Lord's table, and therefore it is an open table, and all are welcome to come. It does not matter what your church background is or if you don't have any at all. If you believe in the love of Jesus, if you desire his love in your life, you are welcome to come to the table this morning. And so with that, I say to us all, come, come, eat, drink, and be fed with the bread of life.
heaven, filled with his praises. One day when sin was as black as could be, Jesus came forth to be born of a virgin, dwelt among men, my example is he. Word became flesh and the light shined among us, his glory revealed. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, rising he justified, really forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day, glorious day. One day they led him up Calvary's mountain. One day they nailed him to die on a tree, suffering anguish, despised and rejected, bearing our sins, my Redeemer is he. The hand that healed nations stretched out on a tree and took the nails for me. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, rising he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day. One day the grave could conceal him no longer. One day the stone rolled away from the door. And he arose, over death he had conquered. Now is ascended, my Lord, evermore. Death could not hold him, the grave could not keep him from rising again. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, rising he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day, glorious day. One day the trumpet will sound for his coming. One day the skies with his glories will shine. Wonderful day, my beloved one bringing. My Savior Jesus is mine. Cause living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, rising he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day. Glorious day,
The whole gospel in one song right there.
My friends, may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Will you pray with me, please? Almighty and ever-loving God, we give you thanks for the gift of this day and your presence in it. And we know that you are present in all of our days. This morning, I would pray that you would make us aware of that presence in amazing and astounding ways. As we head into our week, Holy Spirit, open our eyes to the amazing grace that is always around us. Open our eyes to the fact that we can be extenders of God's grace to others. And open our hearts to receive the grace that is ours. Lord, we know that our world is broken in many, many places and in many ways. And sometimes it seems overwhelming. Sometimes the task seems to be too big, and we get to a place where we don't feel like we can make a difference. But Spirit, remind us, stir up in us that passion for making the difference in even one life makes an eternal difference. Help us be spreaders of your unconditional love to the people that we encounter this week. We pray this in your name and power, Jesus. Amen. There are a few announcements before we go today. First of all, if you're newer around here, or if you're not newer, but you haven't filled out one of these cards, there are cards like this that are back. If you look in the back, where Mancia is standing back there in the red dress, she's holding them. These are cards, these are informational cards, and we invite you to fill them out and hand them either to one of the ushers or don't put them in the offering basket because they're taking that away at the moment. No, that's fine. Go. You can just take it. You can drop it in the offering basket or one job. You can take it. It's okay. You can hand your cards to somebody right by the door or we promise we're not going to spam you all over the place. We're not going to sell your information, nothing like that. But we do want you to know what's going on in our community. And so the one thing that if you turn this in, we will sign you up for is our e-newsletter that comes out every other week. But it also makes sure that we know who you are. So take the time, pick one of these up. You can fill it out. And if you'll remember to bring it back, you can bring it back. Otherwise, just take a moment to fill it out. That would be great.
So newer is like newer in being here. It's not like those people over there. Most of the newer people.
Newer people. Yeah, no, it's yeah. I'm no, it's newer to being here.
To be newer to being here.
Yes.
Yeah,
okay. Yes. Exactly. But if some of those newer people are a part of your you, then by all means, there's space for them on the back. Awesome. Yes. That's right. And we are getting closer and closer and closer to kids camp. And so there are still ways that you can help. Our tagline, right? Even if you don't like kids, there's a place for you at kids camp where you can help. And right now we are getting all the supplies we need for the service projects that kids will do during the week. And so the plan is to make 100 birthday kits. So birthday kits are like when you are... When food is scarce in your home, it is not the first thing on your list to buy a cake mix and frosting and balloons and things like that for a birthday. And so we'll be packing birthday kits for families to pick up as they pick up food in our area food shelters. We're also going to create 600 snack bags and that will go to a variety of places as well. And so you can help out with that. Scan the QR code. Or you can talk to Kristen. I think I saw her. She's back there. There, all the way in the back. But she's around, and you can talk to her as well about. She'll be in. You're going to be in the lobby, right, Kristen? Afterwards. Sure. Awesome. That was the instructions that I was given for you. So
it's a well-oiled machine.
It is well-oiled. Yes. So, but Kristen would be happy to talk to you about those service projects. So, and then Natasha, our drummer, will also be hanging around after worship. And if you would like to still support, there's still time, right? There's still time to support her and her mission and work with those who are a part of the adult entertainment trade. And she's still collecting items that she can take with her to the next convention that they'll be going to, which is in July here down in Florida. I want to keep saying Atlanta, but Florida. And so you can chat with her, scan the QR code on the screen that takes you to their Amazon wish list as well. Yep. Okay. So now we have a chance to celebrate someone who has been someone's who have been a part, often an unseen part of our community. I want to invite Joanne and David to come on up, if you would, please. Joanne. You're a part of this too, David. So when was it, 1996?
About the week before Easter.
1996, about the week before Easter, one of the staff members came to Joe and said, "We know that this isn't really your spiritual gift, but we need somebody to clean the building. Would you be willing?" And so since that time, Joanne and David and their sons and their daughters-in-laws and the whole family have been a part of helping keep this place we call Faith clean, with the preschool downstairs, up here. And David have decided that that they'd like to do something other than clean toilets but which is a very important job that you, that's right, you get to clean your own at home. And so they are officially retiring from us here at Faith and in their role as custodian, but we'll still get to see you around here. Yes. And so we're thankful for that. I want to ask you all to join me in thanking them for many, many years of faithful service and something that is probably only noticed when it doesn't go right. Right. So will you join me in thanking them? It's that awkward moment when you just get to stand and receive, right? So this is just a small token of our thanks for all the work that you all have given to this place and the heart and everything. And would you please just extend your hands out as I place my hands on Joanne and David as we pray for this next chapter in their lives. Good and gracious God, we give you thanks for Joanne and David and all of their boys and their whole family that have given so selflessly to the cleaning of this building for so many years. We thank you for their joyful servant hearts and for the myriad of ways that they have served you in this community in over the years. We pray your hand of blessing to continue on them as they enter into a new era of life, and that you would bless them with joy and with that grace abundance and with excitement for the next chapter in this life. Let them be assured always, God, that you go before them, you come behind them, you walk with them every step of every day. We pray this in your name and power, Jesus. Amen. So, do you want to say anything?
Yeah, I do.
Okay. Can you just come back here and we'll pull this? Or here. Here you go. Grab that microphone. Just hold it really close to your mouth. Really close. Nope. A lot closer. Nope. Like that. Because people online need to be able to hear you.
My voice doesn't carry that much. I just wanted to say it's been an honor and a pleasure and a joy to get to know some of you from the very beginning when Thomas was just a little bitty baby. And to be... when he was baptized and through the death of one of our sons, and the support and the love that David and I feel every time we come here and we're here. Sometimes it's been, well, for the last 27 years, it's been every day. I love you all. We love you all. And thank you for this community here that has provided so much love, joy, and a place of peace for me as well. So I love all you guys, every single one of you. Okay.
Ditto.
He said ditto.
David says ditto. All right. Well, thank you, you guys. We'll let you go. So there are cupcakes in the lobby. So if you miss donuts, you're not out of luck. There are cupcakes, and please stop. And there's also a basket for any of you who brought cards and that as well. We thank you again for your friendship and your service and your hearts. Thank you. Well, now will you receive God's blessings as we go from this place? May you feel the breath of the Spirit breathe life into you, the strength of the Spirit empower you, the call of the Spirit carry you forward into the life that God, the Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, has for you. Amen.
Well, let's sing about some grace. Let's sing about believing and seeing.
I thought love was only true in fairy tales, meant for someone else, but not for me. Shame was out to get me. Do 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 do. That's the way it seems. Do 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 do. Disappointment haunted all my dreams. His grace. Now I'm a believer, and not a trace of doubt in my mind. I'm in love. I thought grace was more or less a given thing, but now rob me alone, oh my God. What's the use of trying? Do-do-do-do. All I felt was pain. Do-do-do-do. Then a friend reminded me once again, and I saw his grace. Now I'm a believer, and not a trace of doubt in my mind. 'Cause I'm in love. Ooh, I'm a believer, I can believe it if I try. Fear was out to get me. That's the way it seems. Disappointment haunted all my dreams. Then I saw his grace. Now I'm a believer, and not a trace of doubt in my mind. 'Cause I'm in love. Ooh, I'm a believer, I could believe it if I tried. Yeah, so it's great. Now I'm a believer, and not a trace of doubt in my mind. And I'm a believer, yeah. I'm a believer, yeah. I'm a believer, yeah.
Woo! When you have kids literally dancing out in the foyer.
Exactly. Yes. Well, my friends, ask you, Joe and David, if you guys want to exit as I'm doing this so that you're in the lobby by the time people get out there. My friends, our worship here has ended so that our service in the world can begin. So go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Younger sisters, come on down to that river. Guaranteed you'll never be the same. There's a fountain flowing from the heart of a Savior. Bring your sins and all your guilty stains. Let the river of life wash it all away. Been searching, carrying burdens. You've been lost and looking for a home. You've been drifting, something is missing. You should know that you are not alone. There's a mountain flowing from the heart of a Savior. Bring your sins and all your guilty stains. Let the river of life wash it away. Oh,
come on down to the river.
Cause you are no time to waste on in your heart. Don't be afraid, jump on. The water is fine, it's healing. The river of life covers you up. No time to waste, open your heart and don't be afraid. Jump on in, the water is fine, there's healing in the river of life. Brothers, sisters, come on down to that river. Guaranteed you'll never be the same.
Come on.
There's a fountain flowing from the heart of the Savior. Bring your sins and all your guilty stains. By the blood of Jesus, everything was made. Let the river of life wash it all away.
Come on down to the river.
Oh,
let the river of life wash it all away.